Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you guys are expecting some more car content on the channel today, I'm sorry, I haven't gotten around to it. I've been sidetracked with all my different home projects on fixing stuff on the pool, and today I'm gonna be messing with my sprinkler system. What we're gonna do today is we're gonna replace my old Hunter, normal, just regular scheduling sprinkler system with a Wyze smart system along with a new box. So stay tuned. So before we start on this sprinkler swap for the controller, we'll go over what we have here. So I've got the Wyze 8-zone controller. I've got 9 zones, but for my 9th zone, which is for my bushes and stuff, I might end up piggybacking off of one of these, or I might do another home integration thing out there and have it as a separate zone that runs on a separate schedule aside from the rest of the yard. So this thing comes with this thing. It has a mount on the back here, and it's a pretty simple, just take out your old wire, push it into here. You've got your control wires over here for like the various sensors and all that that you plug here. The main power, which is just a normal barrel plug right here, and the reset button. And over here is your MC, which is your constant, and I'm not sure what the M is for. But that's the main controller itself. It comes with a power supply that you have to plug in. Unlike traditional sprinkler systems, which just has a transformer inside that you have to wire up, this thing comes with a regular plug-in and a little barrel plug over here. The one review that I saw that for this particular model, like everybody gets it, this back piece is broken off. Mine was also broken off too, because it looks like whoever assembled this from the factory over-tightened the bolts and snapped the little pegs inside. So all I did was just put some super glue in there, glued it back so it stays. I was planning to try to use my Hunter box, which was pretty big, to see if that fit, but this thing is like freaking 9.5 or 9.25 inches wide, and the Hunter one is only 9 inches wide, so it was too big to fit into the Hunter housing, so I had to go buy a new housing. So I ended up actually spending $37 plus tax for this Orbit one. You get this at Home Depot or on Amazon. I'll have a link down in the description if you want the same box. This thing probably costs just as much as my stinking controller right there. That controller I paid like $45 for. This thing was $37 plus tax, so it was almost the same damn price. So I got this one instead of the OEM Wyze one that they make that also fits this thing perfectly. The reason why I got this was because it was like $2 more than the Wyze one. I think the Wyze one is like $35. I have a link down in the description too if you want the OEM one. But the reason why I got it was that it came with this GFI right here. The Wyze one comes with a plug, but it's just a single plug that's side mounted. This one is a front mounted one. So I decided to go with this one just because this GFI right here is like $10 or $15 already of the overall price. So that was well worth it just to have that. And once we take out the Hunter one, I'll show you the transformer that we're taking out. You're just gonna have two hot leads and you need to plug it up to this or wire it up to this plug right here. And the beauty of this thing is it has a front plate right here. It comes with a little locking mechanism for the side if you wanna do the tamper lock. It comes with all your screws. It also has this front plate that your thing mounts to. This thing right there lines up with one hole. You probably just have to drill a second hole and it mounts perfectly right there. If you have any other electronics or any other stuff that you want to put in here, you could just mount it all over here too. Transformer is going to fit here. The only problem is the transformer is going to cover the second slot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mount it upside down. Here's another option I was thinking about too. Maybe just using an extension cord. Get the transformer out here, just zip tie it to this back plate, plug it right into there, has plenty of room, mount the controller just normally in the middle here and have plenty of space there. And then I could, behind it, I could put whatever Z-wave or home automation controller I have too to do other stuff. So before I do anything as far as install, I'm gonna go ahead and paint this thing the same color as the house, just to color match everything. While I have it off, I'm just sand this down, prep it, paint it by hand with a roller and a brush just to get everything coated the same exterior color. Because eventually this stuff will fade and start looking like crap after the sun exposure. So I just want to make it the same color as the house and match all the boxes on the side of my house. To make things pretty easy, you could just pop this cover off. It just pops right into there like this. Just pull it right off and it pops right off without really breaking or damaging anything. And then you could just paint everything, just the exterior surfaces, whatever color you need to match your house. Same with this, I'll flip it on the backside, paint all the little edges and everything that's exposed, and then keep the inside gray just the way it is. And then we should be able to have a nice, pretty install. All right, got this box back in here. I put that door back on. I should have kept those hinges unpainted because it caused a big ass issue trying to get those things to snap back in. I ended up having to scrape off a lot of that paint to get it back in there. Overall, I mounted the new Wyze sprinkler controller right there on one of the preset holes. I had to drill the second one. This one is my Zeus 3 relay Z-wave. I'm gonna put it right there. I actually used two of the E-holes right there that lined up on the back. Aside from that, we're gonna get the power supplies in here. This Zeus uses a USB-C, just a regular USB-C power supply. All right, to continue on, I ended up drilling some holes for my wire management. The wires need to come up from the back side of this panel into the Wyze control unit along with that power plug. So I drilled two holes using this little step bit right here. That step bit really makes everything so easy as far as drilling bigger holes. I drilled two holes right there for the zip tie that I'm gonna be holding that transformer down. And then I just used two existing holes for that zip tie right there for that extension I'm gonna do. So this should be pretty good as far as my wire management goes. All right, so before we start, we're gonna go ahead and label the wires with these stickers that come with the Wyze kit. Before we do that, we wanna cut the power inside the panel here. All right, so I disconnected everything. I labeled all the wires. So now that we've labeled everything, we'll start taking the Hunter apart. So you can actually just undo the ribbon cable here from the Hunter, and you can release this whole thing, and this whole control panel comes apart, and you just put that to the side and go ahead and start unbolting everything down here. You just pull this part off too. And then I want to disconnect the power right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and just disconnect this part. Once we get in here, you can just undo the power. Like I said earlier, you wanna make sure all your power is disconnected and turned off on the breaker so you don't electrocute yourself. All three wires out, you go ahead and just undo these. Transformer separated from the main power. So what we wanna do now is undo this conduit or this flex conduit down here. There's a retaining nut usually in here, so you wanna undo that. Probably take apart the strap here so you can move this out of the way. Go ahead and just kind of move everything aside. I could pull the sensor through here too also, kind of get this out of the way. So I'll go ahead and loosen this lock nut using a flathead and a hammer. So this one doesn't have a lock nut, it's just sitting there. So what we want to do next is we want to go ahead and take the front of this off by unscrewing all the screws. We'll go ahead and unbolt the old box out here. So now that we've got everything apart, we want to test fit this thing in here, kind of line everything up and mark the holes. The old holes, I'm gonna have to end up filling those with some silicone or some caulk and then repainting them just so we don't get any water intrusion into those holes, into the stucco. So that one goes there. The main driver here is this one because it's a hard conduit. This other one is gonna be pretty flexible, so you can kind of mold it to wherever it needs to be. Line it up, eyeball it where it needs to be. Make sure this thing is sitting flush. Mark my holes. All right, we got the new blue anchors in. I took out those old anchors. We're gonna go ahead and fill that with some caulk right now and just put some touch-up paint there so I can clean up all this stuff before I put the cover over it. Got the caulk in there now, just let it dry for a little bit, put some paint on there and move on ahead. So now that we've got everything touched up, I'm gonna go ahead and get this thing in, bolt it all up and get everything wired up. course, this half inch hole is not half inch. So I don't know if it's the paint. All right, this half inch hole is not a standard half inch for some reason. I'm about to go get a drill and open that up a little. Definitely not a half inch standard. For some reason, it's smaller than that. I'll have to use this little bit right here to open it up. All right, so next thing we're gonna do is gonna wire up the GFCI. So what we're gonna look for on the back of here, never use the push-in connectors. You always wanna loop around and actually bolt it down. So what we're gonna do is, you look on here, there's a silver bolt and then kind of a goldish, more copper bolt. So the copper is gonna be hot and the silver is gonna be neutral. Neutral is white, copper, or the copper one goes to the black, which is a hot. Your ground goes to the green at the bottom here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and just take these wires out. I'm gonna loop these things with my pliers and then I'm gonna put them in there and screw them in. You look on here, the load side is gonna be on the bottom and then the line side is up top. So the load side is if you ever want to daisy chain it for additional GFCI, and then the line side is coming from the breaker. Finally got that thing in there. You can see how hard it was to get it in there to loop it and actually do it right. I gave up on the ground wire just because you couldn't loop it on that edge, so I just screwed it in or did the compression fit like they wanted you to. And then same with the hot side here, I got it in and everything's nice and tight. So that's the correct way to wire up any kind of outlet, not to use your lazy push connect. I'm gonna go ahead and get this back in, fold it nicely, so that way the wire loops correctly back there. All right, power's in, everything else is in. Get this stuff out of the way. So one of the things I didn't really think about was where I was gonna mount this, because I didn't wanna leave this outside anymore just because the weathering. So I'm gonna go ahead and just mount it in here, right behind everything else. I'm just gonna screw it right into there. Hopefully I can still get good reception in here and we don't have any interference. Go ahead, mount this guy up, get all the wires put through. So what I just realized is I'm about to open up this hole much bigger than the one I made. I wasn't expecting this many wires to go through. So we basically have 9 zones and then 2 common wires plus the sensor wire. So I'm about to drill a couple additional wire holes through here. That way we get into there. All right, so I went ahead and drilled new holes back there, as you guys can see, so I could run all those wires. And then I went ahead and instead of using the USB-C with the power adapter, I'm just pulling 24 volts AC right into this Z-Wave unit from Zeus. It takes 24 volts DC or AC, so I figured I could just use that power right there that's gonna be used for the sensor, remote sensor anyways. So right now, everything's good. It fits well, the transformer fits well. And then I'm just gonna have to run the wires. I did run the additional common wire right here that I'm gonna be doing for that last zone for my bushes via the Z-Wave time schedule. So I'm gonna have to pull that up there once I pull it down here and then wire that into this first circuit. This box has 3 relays. So later on, if I wanna add other stuff like yard lights or something, I still have that option right here. But we'll go back out there, wire up all the zones, which is an easy push the connectors in, and everything else should be pretty straightforward. Pretty much lost all daylight, but luckily I have all these floodlights. As you can see, we've got that sensor in there. I'm gonna have to go wire that through this hole that I drilled out. To do that, I wanna fish these wires. I wanna do it kind of systematically, so that way I go right in the right order. So to wire up the sensor, it'll be S2 and S1, right? So we're gonna be using S1, and the blue is what we're gonna be wiring up to the S1. The white is the sensor ground, so that's just gonna go to the same common ground that we're gonna be using for the power for this. I checked the common on the Hunter, and those are the same. The VAC, those go into the plus and minus on the power. So we're gonna be sharing that power with this unit down here on the plus and minus for the 24 volts. All right, so I got everything wired up. So what I ended up doing was, you see the orange, the yellow, and the blue from the sensor all go over here. I actually put the orange and the yellow, which is one side of the 24 volt AC, on the negative 24 volts, and then the other yellow on the positive. Blue right there for the S1 is the signal for the sensor, and the white, which is a common, I just put it over here with that common, which is the same as the ground on the same ground bus. Over here on this side, I just have the two common grounds right there coming in, and then I had 1 through 8 just plugged straight into there. So I'm gonna go turn this on and see if everything works and if I can connect to it with the app. So I was able to set everything up. I got everything all dialed in, tested every single zone, and did everything in the Wyze app, and everything's all set up now. I got my schedules all done. I still need to tweak it a little bit just to get everything right during the day, and also check all my sprinkler heads. I discovered a few of my sprinkler heads were in places that they shouldn't be. Now that I've covered up some of those areas with other things, so I need to take care of all that. But aside from that, I got to set up this Zeus relay right here with some device handlers for Smartthings, and everything works good and tested, and we're good with this project. Hey guys, thanks for joining me late on this project and getting everything done. As you can see, it's a pretty simple step to set all this up, as long as you keep track of all your wiring and everything and getting all set up. I did go above and beyond with this relay, which took up a lot of my space, but other than that, everything's straightforward, especially with this new enclosure that I got. If you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel to stay on top of all my different DIY videos, go ahead and subscribe to your channel. Turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I upload a video. Remember guys, for all these different DIY projects, whether it's on the car, on the house, in the garage, or whatever, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.